Home cooking and what we did for fun, growing up in the 50s and 60s, stories from my life. Grandma's porch. Sit down, relax, enjoy. Here on Grandma's porch. Home cooking and what we did for fun back in the 1950s and 60s, growing up, stories from my life. Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Breanne. Well, I've been coming on here telling little stories from my life, little bits and clips and snippets, not in alphabetical or chronological order, but just as they come to me. And I just did one called Going Visiting, and what we did back in the 50s and 60s. And so I thought I would talk a little bit more about that period of my life growing up. I was born in the latter 50s, and most of my memories come from the early 60s, although I was a byproduct of the 50s. And life still very much stayed the same in our little town that I grew up in. And so back in the 50s and 60s, you know, we just grew up slowly. There was no milestones. Parents didn't worry about milestones, you know. You just grew up your way. There was no pressure on our childhood other than to be a child. You know, we weren't pressured to learn everything, and we weren't pressured to, you know, be thinking about a career when we were 4 or 5 or 6 years old, as many are today in our society. It was just a very, very simple way of life. I don't give recommendations, information, suggestions. I just share with you my perspective on life, as is with this video. And so back in the 50s and 60s, what I remember is that, well, we had grandma's food or mama's food, and it wasn't fast food, and it didn't have all the chemicals that are in many of the foods today. It was just simple food. Much of our food came from the garden or from the local deli or from the little store down the street. We didn't have big supermarket chains in our town. We had little mom and pop stores, and we would walk to the store and maybe buy a soda pop for 10 cents, or we would, my mom would send me to go get a dozen eggs down at the little grocery store. I remember this one little grocery store I loved to go to. They were all family run. And I remember the people actually lived in their house, and the grocery store was in their house, in the front part of their house. And I used to go there. I loved going there. And it was kind of a place you hung out. Even as a youngster, you'd go get your soda pop and sit on the front step of the mom and pop store and drink your soda. And so grandma's cooking was the real deal. It came from the garden, or it came from the local grocery store, and it was homemade. They made things from scratch. There was no box stuff, you know, pre-made stuff, fast food stuff, no microwave stuff. Everything was cooked on the stove. Grandma had a, you know, she had a coal stove, but then she had like a gas stove in the kitchen. My mom cooked a meal every night. Even when she was going to nursing school, she would come home and make dinner. That was just, or we called it supper. And it could be very simple foods. Most foods were very simple. Back when I was growing up, if you got to eat steak once a week, you were rich. You were rich if you could have steak and or pork chops once a week. And that's how we determine rich. And but we always ate healthy. but most of our food was homemade, if not all of our food was homemade. Relatives got together and baked cookies together and exchanged cookies, especially at Christmas time. When you went to other people's houses, they always invited you to sit down at the kitchen table and you would have something to eat. It wouldn't be complicated food. It was very casual. It wasn't a formal dinner or formal sit down. It was just whatever they had prepared on back of the stove. And you might have a bowl of soup or a piece of chicken or something delicious, but it was all homemade. And nowadays, I feel like people just, you know, drive through the drive-thru, and most people don't sit down together at dinner table. Now, we do as a family. We sit down at our dinner table most nights. And even though I have grown children, they're usually here, and we sit down. Most of my food is homemade. Now, I do buy some other foods. My kids like, you know, certain fast foods, and for the most part, it's all homemade, and most of my food is from scratch, as Grandma would call it, and which is homemade. And so the food was delicious. It was simple. And I think today people are missing out because there's so many added things to food, in my belief, that enhance the flavor the way Grandma's food could not be enhanced. And so often now people don't want Grandma's food. They want this other food because, well, it gives them that, you know, you go get a bag of chips with all these different preservatives and chemicals that enhance the flavor. They can't really compete with Grandma's food. But I think Grandma's food was the best food around. I think it was just delicious and amazing. My mama's food, learning to cook. We cooked together. We worked in the kitchen together. We helped clean up dishes together. So that's how we ate in the 1950s, and families sat down at the dinner table. And they didn't have a cell phone. And if the phone rang, if you were lucky enough or blessed enough to have a phone, you didn't answer it during the dinner table. You waited. And there was no answering machines back then, so the answering machine didn't pick it up. And if there was a TV show on at dinner time, you didn't watch it. You just missed it. You didn't have a VCR or something to record it with. Life was really simple. We had rabbit ears to our TV and one TV channel. Sometimes we would get two on a really good day, but it was usually fuzzy. TV shows were very simple, very digestible, and very family oriented. Even the ones that kids didn't watch were still within what I think the guidelines today would be of family oriented. And kids played outside. We played outside. We played in the yard. We played board games on rainy days. We didn't have virtual games, and we really didn't watch much TV because there wasn't much on one channel. And sometimes cartoons would come on and we would watch that together. Or like if there was, I remember with my friend Kirby growing up, I was 5 years old. That Girl was on and he loved That Girl. So we'd go over and we'd watch the TV show together. That Girl, I Love Lucy. Well, it was Here's Lucy when I was growing up. I Love Lucy was in reruns in the morning even then. And Honeymooners and all those amazing, wonderful TV shows from the past. They really, really, really were wonderful. And very simple, digestible life. People visited each other, kids played in the yard, kids played outside all day and then came in the evening. Parents didn't worry about where they were at. They usually knew where they were at. And it was just a very, very different time period. We didn't go to restaurants. I don't think I went to any kind of restaurant until I was about 12 or 13. And even then, I think it was just a kind of like a Dairy Queen restaurant. I do remember the only fast food that we had in my town was a Dairy Queen. And I used to stop there on the way home from school with a dime and get what they called a Mr. Misty. It was like a frozen drink and I loved it. It was like a slushy back then. It was so good. And that was really, and sometimes if I had enough, I would get me a fish sandwich. And then later they built a Burger King down the street. It was called Burger Chef. It wasn't Burger King, it was Burger Chef, sorry. Burger Chef. And then I don't know, I think they phased that out later. And so it was Burger Chef. And then, but that was all we really had. And that was a real treat to go there. It wasn't until later that we ever really went to restaurants. I think closer to 18 when I really started going to real restaurants. And because times were starting to change at that particular point. And by then I was living in California. by 19. And so life had changed a bit for me. But yeah, that's what we did. We got together, we had conversations, or we played when we were kids. TV shows were simple. The food was delicious. It was grandma's food, very simple. Most of the time, like I said, it was casual, sit down. You know, people came to visit, they sat down, they had a bite to eat. It wasn't like we all had to do something very, very formal. It was very casual and wonderful. Well, from my house to yours, I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five channels. Links are pinned at the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me, I will likely connect with you as well with all five. May God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. Bye-bye. To relax.